last song, you missed the lead by Sister Thelma. She was singing. Thank you very much. God is great and worthy to be praised. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. This is Pentecost Sunday, so I don't want us to miss that as we celebrate the day that the Holy Spirit was finally delivered to the disciples. Amen. Found in Acts, and the tongues of fire came. And we need to understand that everything that we do is only because of the Holy Spirit. We cannot do anything. The Holy Spirit, the Greek name is the Paraclete, and that means it is our helper, our guide, our strength, our coach, our exhorter. The Holy Spirit is always behind us in all that we do. And so without the Holy Spirit, we would be, it is truly the Spirit of the living God that lives within us. Amen? And so we need to understand this. And so one of the things that I need to correct right away is I talk to people and people in the church who they'll be talking to me and they will say, well, Pastor, you know, a voice told me that I should do this. A voice told you. If you are a child of God, inside of you is the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is speaking to you all the time. The Holy Spirit is there trying to help you do this thing right. Amen? Amen. And so there are many voices in our heads. Amen. But when it is a voice that guides you in the way of the Lord, now the problem is the only way we know the way of the Lord is if we read the Lord's Word. Amen? So that we know that the voices that we hear are contrary to the Word of God, that we know that's not the Lord. But the voices that we hear that are within the bounds of the Word of God, those that are good, those that are kind, we know that it is not a voice, it is the Holy Spirit speaking to us. Amen? We all, when you give your life to Christ, we all have the Holy Spirit that begins to work in our lives. Amen? So that you can pay attention or not. That's up to you. But the Holy Spirit, and watch this, this is how you know the Holy Spirit is speaking in your life. I'll go back to a voice tells you to do something. You decide you're not going to do it. And something goes drastically wrong and you look back and go, I would have done it with that voice. That was the Holy Spirit. Okay. Amen? The Holy Spirit is trying to guide us and to do it. The Holy Spirit is always there to help us. And so in times of need, pray, Holy Spirit, speak to me clearly that I might be able to hear. The Holy Spirit is always working on our behalf. And so we celebrate Pentecost, which is always 50 days after Easter. Amen? That's why Penta is the big word for 50. So that's Pentecost. All right? I'm working on the series, Rules of Engagement. Amen? And the three simple words, which I'm sure you all remember, what are they?
Do no harm.
Do no harm.
Do good. Love God.
Do no harm. Do good. Stay in love with God. Amen. So we've already talked about do no harm. First it was do no harm with the words of our mouth. And I know we've all been working on that one, right? That is a work in progress for us all. Amen. Amen. Because we have to make sure that the words that come out of our mouth bring people to God, not have people chase people away. Amen? And some of us are gifted with our mouths, and we can chase people far away very fast. Amen? And so we have to pump the brakes on what comes out of our mouth. But the first thing we have to do is go to Psalm 51 and ask the Lord to create in me a clean heart. Amen? Because the Bible tells us that what comes out of our mouth starts in our heart. So if you got nasty and ugly in your heart, we know what's going to come out your mouth. Amen. So Lord, created me a clean heart and a steadfast spirit. Lord, cleanse me out. Every wrinkle, every blemish, everything on the inside, so that stuff won't come out on the outside. And this is a continued request, amen. We have to work on this every single day. But we do no harm with our mouths, and then we do no harm to ourselves. Y'all remember that? Do no harm to ourselves, because sometimes if we're not taking care of ourselves, if we're not taking care of ourselves, we can't do what God has called us to do. I'm too tired, man.
You're tired because you're staying up all night watching TV.
Yeah. Yeah. You're tired because you haven't been eating right. You're tired because you only drink one cup of water every day. Help me, Lord. We have to take care of ourselves so that we can do the work. You're tired because you ain't been to the doctor in 3 years. I'm talking to the brothers now. Help me, Lord. Hey, brother. I can welcome everybody who's on the internet. When I was at the annual conference, I found a lot of people looking at us on the internet. And I see you every Sunday. So hello, everybody on the internet. Amen. Within a month, we'll have a way that you can share with us, not only this worship experience, but the worship experience we're offering. Praise the Lord. We're going to have electronic giving for those who are unable to be with us. They'll be able to give it to us. Amen. And for those of us who don't carry cash, we'll be able to just hit primarily out of James, the first chapter, 19 through 21. And it's a very familiar text for those who know it. It is about not being more than just hearers of the words, but doers of the word. Amen? Got a story to tell you one more time. This is the last word I'll tell you. Until the next letter. And so I've been on the almost athletic things. So I got to talk to you about when I was in high school. In high school, I ran track. We were getting ready for the track season, and we had someone who transferred in. And he was a new guy. He comes up to all of us. So I'm like, oh, man, what do you do? He said, I run track. I'm like, okay. So what do you mean do you run? I run 100-yard dash. I said, really? He said, yeah. He said, everybody, oh, man, you run the 100. You got a sprinter. I said, how fast do you run? And he said, I run 10 flat. Now, for those who don't know, if you run 10 flat, you're really fast. You are very, 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 very fast. And so we looked at my man like, you run 10 flat? Are you sure you run 10 flat? Yeah, I run 10 flat. I've done this. So we found out. So we didn't even know his name. We just called him 10 flat. From then on, he was called 10 flat. I still, to this day, do not know his name, but he is 10 flat. And so we were all looking forward to seeing 10 flat run. And so we got ready, and we track practice finally started, and we saw 10 flat run, and we're like, well, he's not running real fast. Like, what's up, 10 flat? You know, look at that. And 10 flat said, man, he sounded like, for those who know, he sounded like Allen Iverson. It's only practice, bro. It's only, I've been working hard on practice. I like to run as fast as I can run in practice. I don't want to show off. Oh, Tim Flack could talk some trash. Tim Flack was just talking and talking. Everybody he did this, he did that. He was the fastest man wherever he came from. And you know, we didn't have an internet where we could check up on him, so we had to believe Tim Flack. So finally, track season came. And we went to our first track meet, and so everybody's waiting. Oh, Tim Flack will burn the track. Like, stop that. Tim Flack will burn up the track. He's always been on that. And so they got in the 100, and they on your bar, get set, boom, and they took off. Tim Flack can't get dead last. Everybody beat Tim Flack. We what's wrong with Tim Flack then? Tim Flack, oh man, I got a bad start, man.
Afternoon, that they may hear your word and take it in and do something with it.
This is our prayer. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We're talking about doing good. Now, there's a lot of places in the Bible, all throughout the Bible, that tells us as children of God we should do good. Galatians 6, 9 and 10, it says, "Let us not become weary in doing good. For at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Therefore, as we have the opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of believers." Last week we talked about Luke 26, which said, "Love your enemies and do good to those who hate you." There's a Moses and Rose about that. Psalms 37 and 3, "Trust in the Lord and do good." Ecclesiastes 3 and 12, "I know that there is nothing better for men than to be happy and to do good while they are alive." So doing good, doing what God tells us to do good is a part of being a child of God. So this is the word. Our scripture said from Joshua, it said, "Make sure that you have the words of God, the Lord, on your lips and meditate them on day and night so that when you do them and when you do them, you will be blessed." The word is that we need to do good. We need to do good. And doing good, the definition of doing good is to be of benefit to someone. So in other words, our lives, our actions, because we are so blessed and highly favored, our actions are there. We need to bless and help somebody by the good works that we do. We are all blessed in this place in the name of Jesus. I look out into the parking lot. I don't see a buggy and a horse anywhere. Everybody rolled up in nice cars. Everybody's looking good. Everybody, we are blessed. Do you agree that we are blessed in the name of Jesus? We are blessed and highly favored. And the Bible tells us that we are blessed to be a blessing. We are blessed not to hoard everything that the Lord allows us to have. We are blessed so that we can bless others. We are blessed so that we can bless others with the things that we have. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Because we all went through our closets. Amen. In the name of Jesus, we have more clothes than we can wear. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We have clothes that are in the closet that don't even fit. In the name of Jesus. Haven't fit in a long time. I go through it. I've been going through my stuff. And it's not that it doesn't fit, but I have such memories. I remember when I wore this. I have a suit that's two sizes too small.
Yeah.
And I have absolutely no thought that I'm ever gonna get down that side again. But all me and this suit, we did some great things. and so I hang it right back up. Some people, I don't know your name. I'm not gonna talk about anybody's name, but some people have clothes in your closet that still have tags on. My wife is pushing me along. But we are blessed. The Bible tells us if we're going to do good, we need to clothe the naked. We need to feed the hungry. I know we have cans and cans. We collect cans. But if we really made an effort in the name of Jesus to look through your cupboard with all the cans, you have stuff in there you don't even like. Amen.
Somebody might use some spam. I ain't gonna eat no spam ever again.
I am done with spam. But you understand, we have food in our cupboards that we can help somebody. But if we wanted to, I bet we could bring 200 cans. I bet we could. Plant the seed right there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
200 cans. Can we do that?
Yeah.
Can we do that? We can overwhelm the pantry. 200 cans just coming from us just because we're gonna do good. And we're blessed. We're blessed. If you just took out a couple of cans and stuff, you know you ain't gonna never eat. The ones that still ain't, go back and get the can, you can write your name on it because it's so dusty. Amen. We have clothes. Let's see. Oh, I didn't even talk about shoes, did I? Most of us have more shoes than we can wear. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Shoes that out of style, shoes that we don't want to wear anymore. Woo! Amen, clock. Amen. Clock don't have no shoes, but and now, hold up, my wife's here, hold on. Move the camera, bring it up. I got to wear you. Some of us have more shoes in our closets than we can wear.
Yes.
Amen.
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 And now.
Don't be scared.
Folks, gotta get behind this thing here. Most women have more purses. Give it back to you. Pressed out, shaking together, overflow. I'm glad we don't have no dumpling cake. Nobody be buying a ton of dumpling fat in the day. Church, say amen.
Amen.
God is good and worthy to be praised. So the Bible tells us, look, it says that you are supposed to accept the word that has been planted in you. The word that has been planted in you says do good. The word that has been planted in you says give. It says go and visit the sick. Go and visit those who are in prison. Go and help somebody. That is the word that comes from God that has been planted in you. And if you take the word that has been planted in you, do what it says. Don't deceive yourself. Oh, Lord, it's going to be quiet.
Come on.
Don't deceive yourself and think that just because you hear the word, that's as far as God wants you to take it. Oh, I come to church. Yeah, I wonder why people come to church. I come to church to hear the word. No. You should be coming to church to hear the word and then so that you are getting inspired and encouraged for you to go out and do something with what you hear. I can preach to this cabin. And this cabin can receive the word. And in many cases, the candle does, at least it's burning.
That's right.
Well,
yeah. Amen, candle.
Amen.
You see, we've got to take this work, and we've got to do something. That's what we've done. And here's what I talked about this last week. Here's what I want you to do. What we are supposed to be doing, God has already given you. Whoa. I was sitting here talking myself today. You've got it already. He planted it in you. The Bible says that the one you already have one gift.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
So you've got it. So what are you gonna do with it? You gonna do 10 flat?
Use it.
Huh? We've got every gift that is needed for this church, for this community, we've all got it. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Yeah.
You got it. God has given to us all because God knew that since the beginning of time that we were going to be right here on this Sunday morning. God knew that we were going to be part of this place called St. Matthew's. He knew it. He set it all up. And he said, Pastor, I need you to go by there and tell them I've already planted in them, but if they don't do anything, I can't help them.
That's this.
I just need somebody to come out and say, Lord, I'll do something. You've given me all these gifts. You've given me everything that you've given me, Lord God. And you see, we have to get comfortable being uncomfortable.
Yes.
Because what God tells us to do, it's not going to be comfortable. Oh, it's going to mess up my routine. I can't watch my shows no more.
Well.
Now, you can watch that show. You tell me when that show blesses you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I always tell my boys, even football season, I'm a diehard football fan. And I've been an Oakland Raiders fan my entire life. And in fact, back in the day, I met Al Davis, who's the owner of the Oakland Raiders. I told him, I said, Al, I've been an Oakland Raiders fan since the 1960s. I remember when you came to Oakland. I remember everything. And he looked at me and said, He didn't give me a dollar. I have $500 worth of Raider attire. He ain't give me a dollar. And say thank you for being a fan. No.
And he got it.
No. And yet my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, my God sent Jesus to die for me. He did so. Amen.
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 And so we have this salvation. And he's saying, just do this. Just do a little bit of good.
Yes.
If you just do something a little bit different than you've done before. He has blessed us to be creative and innovative, to be bold and courageous and not afraid. He has blessed us because what he's going to ask us to do, we ain't going to want to do. Because trouble. Because if God gave you something and you're scared to do it because of the money, I'm buying that in the name of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? You're standing here in a place that lets you know that God has all the money.
Yeah.
Huh? Didn't y'all build this in a depression?
Yeah.
When the money was ugly and ugly? The money was ugly and uglier? But God made a way out of nowhere. So tell me this. Has your God lost his power? He has. So therefore, and so I do not believe that the end was to build this building. This was just a beautiful place to come so that we could get inspired and get excited to say, we're going to go out and tell somebody about Jesus Christ. We're going to live a life that means that we're going to do something for Jesus. We're going to help the homeless. We're going to help people with drug problems, because there is a drug problem right down here. And there's things that we need to do. We need to do something. Even if we just send a letter, say, Pastor, we need to send a letter down to Annapolis to tell somebody that there's drug problems here and we want to do something about it. We need to do something. That's what we have been called to do. We have not been called just to talk about it, be on the phone and gossip about it. We've been called to do something about it. We can no longer sit silently and quietly. Look, and I'm getting ready to go. I got 3 minutes. I got 5 minutes. Terry White. Church has changed. See, it's going to change for the black church, because as we grew up in the black church and our parents and our grandparents, when they grew up, the black church was a place of safety. They came because that was really the only place that we could come and get together and do our own thing. Right? Everywhere else, everybody was looking at us and trying to stop us from doing that or keeping us down. But in the church, we could come and do great things. But in those days, everybody came to church. And so when the church did things, we knew everybody in the community, because everybody came and we could do everything. It's changed. And you can look around and see. People don't come to church like they used to. People rarely come. And so what we have to do, if they won't come into church, the church has to go out to them. In the name of Jesus. Because we are the church. We are the basis of the church has not changed. We share the love of Jesus Christ to make disciples to change this world. Amen? That's what we do. We always have done it. But if they're not coming in here, our mission has not changed. We have to go out and do them. We have to go out and get them. We have to go out and at least testify them. We have to go out and touch somebody. Go out and say something. Go out and hug somebody. We've got to do good. We're the only ones who can show who God is. It's us. Say your name, your neighbor. We are the only ones who can show who Jesus is.
Show who Jesus is.
That's our call. That's our call. That's what we're called to do. And it's doing good. It's about actively and proactively trying to figure out what is it that as a church we can do. There's something that we can do. Somebody needs something. Whether it's a GED program, somebody needs something. Alcoholics Anonymous, Narcotics Anonymous, somebody needs something that we need to say. We're behind it because we've seen the ills of the world and God has told us to do something. It's not about just coming to church on Sunday and being satisfied that you've heard a word and you're going to be 10 flat. Absolutely not about that. And it doesn't all come from me. Watch this. And Sidney Bond probably heard that. One of the things that they said at the annual conference, as they looked at the sheep and the shepherd, they said, sheep make sheep. Sheep make sheep. The shepherd does not make a single sheep.
That's right.
And so then they said, disciples make disciples. It's not up to the shepherd to make the disciples. So we have to get busy. We have to invite people to church every Sunday. The people who turn me down on Sunday after Sunday after Sunday, the people say, I'm coming, and they never show up. We must continue to invite them and show them the love of Christ and let them know. And then if they won't come, just share them with Jesus wherever they are. Because you know the ones that you invite. I'm going to come to church. Will you come to church with me? Yeah, I'll be there. Drop a word on them right there. That may be the last time you see them for me. Because most of the neighbors come to church. They may come today, but we're eating food. We have food to serve to them. We might get a few people come in that won't come in this building. But that's the thing, a lot of people don't even want to come in the church building. But we are the church. Everywhere we go, we are the church. And we're commanded to do good. We're commanded to be a benefit to somebody by understanding the blessing that God has given us. And God has blessed us immensely, amen?
Yes,
and continues to bless us immensely. Amen? So our charge is to do good. We do no harm. And we do no harm, that means people see a different look at us. Even when we should say something, we don't say something because we know that God is on our side. Our vocabulary changes and people will see that and people will understand that because we do no harm. And then we do good. We bless people. We can bless people as God has blessed us. We don't. It's not reciprocal because God's blessing on us is not reciprocal.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
So we don't wait, I'm going to bless you if you bless me. Well, if God did that, we'd all be going to hell. Amen? Amen? So my call this morning is that as we talk about doing good, we can all do that. We all have something that God has given us to do good, to help somebody out. Even as a kid in the community that wants to go to camp, we can do that.
We can do that. Yes. Amen.
There's nothing we can't do. your child to church, send your child to camp, we're going to bless you to do it. I'll bet you that person will come to church.
Amen.
I'll bet you they'll come to church. Amen. And then we can love on them some more. We're like, you see what I'm saying? Do good leads to good things.
Amen.
Amen. We have to do it and not be afraid. God has got us. God will never take us any place where he wasn't going to bless us immensely. God has got us. And if we are willing to take what God tells us and just begin to do it, what God does is he lifts us out of our normal and takes us to the miraculous. So we don't even consider that the things that God told us to do, that there's another place, there's another realm, and God will make us do the miraculous because he's God. And some of us will say, how did you do that? And then you got a testimony. So the ministry that God has given you, this is my second week. I got like 4 more weeks to do it. The ministry that God has given you, it's like time to get busy. It's time to get busy. It's not time to hold back. I don't have this, I don't have that. No, my excuses are done. God has called us to do good. In the name of Jesus. Stand up, all of us. I got one amen. Can the church say amen?
Amen.
I know these words are tough, but God is saying, look here, we can't always, I can't always preach you happy.
That's it.
I've got to preach you into action. Amen? Because we got to make other people happy. And so that's how the Lord works. And sometimes it's difficult delivering a message, but it's what it is needed. It's what God has called us to do. It's why God has blessed us. It's why we are the church of God. Church of God, that we might be able to do good, that we might be able to bless somebody. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless you. We thank you for the challenges. And we thank you, Lord God, when you put it in front of us and make it plain. Help us, Lord God, to see that you have called us into action. You have called us to take all of the blessings, all of the training. You created us to do good works. So that we can bear good fruit. Help us, Lord God, that we are not satisfied where we are, but that we press to do what you call us to do. And we will give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. In the awesome name of Jesus, we pray. And all God's children say, amen.
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 And amen. We give the Lord a hand.
Thank you to everyone who joined us this morning. Please check us out again next Sunday. Check out our upcoming events. Join us. We would love to see you and have you. Have a blessed day, blessed week, and see you next Sunday.